all I. See, now cost sheet. For cost sheet, yesterday I have explained about element of cost. What beta? Element of cost. So that was very important because that is totally connected with this. So in element of cost, direct cost and indirect cost. So in direct cost, right? I have explained you. In direct cost, direct material, direct wages, direct expenses, all will be totaled, then you will get prime cost. Right? Clear? So always remember this, direct cost, if all the direct cost will be added, if all the direct cost will be added, that is known as prime cost. And after prime cost, indirect cost will start. After prime cost, what will start, beta? Indirect cost will start. Okay? Now see. See, for solving the sums, this is what pro forma of cost sheet, where your cost sheet will be like this. Step, element of cost, two columns, rupees. This is what inner column and this is outer column. Okay. So inner column means if there is any adjustment, if there is any addition or subtraction, then you have to write it inner column. Then you have to write it in inner column. That's it. Okay. So now let's begin with the cost sheet format. The format of cost sheet, which you have to remember it by heart. Very important. Okay. Right. Now you have to solve the sums like this. So here only XX means just amount, assuming amount. Right? When we're going to solve the sums, we will take here the amount. Don't worry. Now see, first step. First direct cost. First one is what, beta? Your direct cost. And I explained you today and yesterday also. Okay, direct cost total. All the total of direct cost is what? Prime cost. And I have explained yesterday also. Right? So see, so direct cost consists with direct materials, direct labor, direct expenses, right? So for producing this pen, there is a materials. These all are the materials, right? Which is directly involved in the production of this pen, right? And who produced this? Who produced this? By the help of labor. So labor cost is also there, which is directly involved in this. Right? So that is what direct labor and whatever direct expenses. Like if we don't have the technique, we have taken techniques of another. We have used the technique of another firm or another business organization. Then at that time, we have to pay what? Royalty to them. So that is also linked directly to the production of this pen. So those are known as what? Direct expenses. Now see, now the first one is what? Direct materials. Whatever material you required for the purpose of production, that is what? Directly connected to production. Directly connected to production of those product, those goods. Got it? Now, for direct material, you have to remember these steps. This is the formula. Right? So see, in direct material, first, opening stock of raw material. Material means raw materials, because if you have the raw material, then only you will going to produce the products. Then only you will going to produce the final product. Finished goods. Final product means finished goods. Right? So your material, first one is what? Your material. Then next, material will be processed. That is work in process. And finally, it will in the stage of finished goods. There are three steps you have studied earlier, right? Raw materials, then processing, that is work in process, and finally finished goods, right? Clear? So after finished goods, there will be a final product. Okay. So first one is what? Direct material, where you have to remember this formula. That is, first one is what? Opening stock of raw material. Whatever raw material stock has been left last year, that you have to brought forward. Right? Last year opening stock you have to brought forward here. ऐसा नहीं कि लास्ट ईयर का रॉ मटेरियल तो फेंक दिया, नहीं ऐसे नहीं बाबा. यू हैव टू ब्रॉट फॉरवर्ड दैट रॉ मटेरियल्स. दैट इज व्हाई ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल अमाउंट यू हैव टू राइट इट इन योर इनर कॉलम, बिकॉज देयर विल बी अ कैलकुलेशन प्लस माइनस, बिकॉज इट्स अ फॉर्मूला. देन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू एड. नाउ लास्ट ईयर ओपनिंग स्टॉक इज देयर, नाउ यू हैव टू एड व्हाट materials, what raw material you have purchased in this year, what material you have purchased in this year, that is purchase of raw material, current purchase, right? Clear? What? Current purchase, right? So second one is what? Your purchase of raw materials. What beta? Purchase of raw materials. Okay. So first one is what? Opening stock of raw material. Second one, purchase of raw materials. Okay, then if you have purchased raw materials, so whatever carriage or freight for bringing those raw materials will be there. Carriage or freight, transport expenditure, whatever it will be there, right? For bringing those material, that also will be added, like carriage inward, freight inward, because in or in a factory mein aa raha hai beta. That is why carriage inward or freight inward is direct cost related to that product, related to that materials. So that is why that will be what beta? Added, right? Clear? So opening stock of raw materials, then add what? Purchase of raw materials. And what you have to do, you have to add what? What you have to add? Expenses on purchase like carriage inward or freight inward. Or there are so many, right? Like custom duty, dock dues, right? But remember these two, right? So carriage or freight. At the time of purchase, whatever carriage or whatever freight inward you have paid, that will be added in direct material, right? So what is the formula? Opening stock of raw material, you have added what? Purchase of raw material. Then what you have added? Expenses on purchase. So expenses on purchase is nothing but what? Carriage inward or freight inward. Okay. Clear? Now deduct, that is less purchase returns of raw materials. If any defective raw material is there, then what we will going to do? Aarti utarenge, are baba ye to defective hai. No, we will return it. We will return back. So that is what purchase returns. Now if you return it, then you have to deduct it, na? It's common sense. Your raw material will going to reduce. That is why you have to deduct it, right? So less purchase returns of raw materials. And finally, opening stock of raw material is added. Now closing stock of raw material. If there is any closing stock of raw material at the end, if there is any closing stock of raw material left at the end, that you have to deduct. Because that has not been used. अरे वो मटेरियल तो आपका क्लोजिंग स्टॉक हो गया, वो यूज ही नहीं हुआ तो खर्चा कैसे लेगा उसको. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट मटेरियल कंज्यूम्ड कितना किया, हाउ मच मटेरियल वी हैव कंज्यूम्ड. सो इफ क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल इज देयर, तो क्लोजिंग स्टॉक मींस यू हैव नॉट कंज्यूम्ड दैट, ना? तो यू हैव टू डिडक्ट इट ना बेटा. इफ यू हैव नॉट कंज्यूम्ड, देन यू हैव टू डिडक्ट इट, राइट? सो दैट इज व्हाई closing stock of raw material is deducted. And finally, using all this formula and all the calculation, we will get this amount, this, that is net material consumed. But beta, we will get this amount, that is what? Net material consumed. Here you can see here, net material consumed. Okay, clear bacha? Now see, review it. So for direct material there are steps. So what are the steps for direct materials? Opening stock of raw material plus purchase of raw material plus expenses on purchase like carriage inward, freight inward, all that, right? Then less purchase returns, whatever you have returned it, defective pieces, whatever it will be, that you have to deduct it. And after that, what closing stock is there? Whatever closing stock has been left, that also you have to deduct it. Then only you will get your material consumed. Then only you will get to know how much material we have consumed. What is the amount? What is the cost of that material consumed? Got it? Clear? So this is what net material consumed. Okay? Everyone clear? Pakka? So remember it. This is the formula. Clear? Direct material ka formula. Everyone have to remember it. Opening stock of raw material plus purchase of raw material plus expenses on purchase. Expenses on purchase means carriage or freight inward or dock dues, custom duty, whatever. Less purchase return of raw material than closing stock of raw material. Okay? Finally, we will get material consumed. What? Material consumed. That is net material consumed. Now, this is what? What? Under the heading of direct materials. Now, the next is what? See, yesterday I told you, I explained you, there are three direct costs: direct material done, then direct labor. What beta? Direct labor means labor work, right? They are directly involved in producing those product. They will convert those raw material into processing and then finally finished goods, right? So direct wages, unko jo bhi wages doge, whatever labor will be given, that is what direct labor cost. And finally, direct expenses. Whatever expenses directly linked to that product, like royalty based on production. We are giving royalty. If we don't have technique, we are using someone's technique, then we are paying. We will pay or we have to pay some amount to them. That is known as royalty. So that is directly linked to that production of goods, right? Royalty or any higher charges for special tools and equipments. We are using some tools and equipments which is directly linked to that product. So whatever the higher charges we are paying, that is also our direct expenses, because that is directly linked to that product's production. So remember it. So what you have to remember? First, direct material, then direct labor or direct wages, finally direct expenses. All three will be added. Then we will get our prime cost. We will get our prime cost. So this is very important, right? That is why I have highlighted this, right? Prime cost. So how we will get the prime cost? From direct material, direct labor, direct expenses. Direct material, direct labor, direct expenses. Add all the three points, we will get our prime cost. That's it. Clear? And under this direct material, you have to remember it. Formula: opening stock of raw material plus purchase of raw material plus expenses on purchases, like carriage inward, freight inward, all that, less purchase returns of raw material, whatever defective raw material you have returned, that you have to deduct it. And finally, whatever closing stock has been left at the end of the year, that you have to deduct it. Right? So this is what your prime cost. This is what, after calculating all, after adding all three, that is direct material, direct labor, and direct expenses, you will get prime cost. Only remember the calculation under this direct material formula of this direct material, that is opening plus purchase plus purchase expenses, whatever it will be, carriage or freight, less purchase returns and less closing stock of raw material. Then you will get net material consumed, and then direct labor or direct wages, then direct expenses, and finally prime cost. Clear? So this is the base, and this all is known as your direct cost. What? These all are the what, beta? Your direct cost. Okay? So everyone have to keep in their mind direct material, direct labor, direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, total prime cost, and under direct material, these formula. Clear? This is prime cost. Now, prime cost means direct cost. Now, move to next. After prime cost, because if you want to find out total cost of the product, you have to know prime as well as indirect cost also. So add direct plus indirect both, then you will get total cost of product. Then you will get what, beta? Total cost of product. Now move to indirect cost. Now see, indirect cost. Now, indirect cost. Indirect cost. See, yesterday lecture, in yesterday lecture, indirect cost element. Review it. What? Factory overheads. Factory overhead is also known as work overheads. What, beta? Factory overhead is also known as work overheads. Then kya tha? Factory overhead, after factory overhead, office and administration overheads, then finally selling and distribution overheads. Okay, now see, now from E, right, up to D are prime cost. Now move to E, step number E. Now from here, indirect cost will start. Right, indirect cost will start. Now, prime cost plus all this will be added. Then finally, you will get your total cost. Right? Now, see, step number E, work overheads. What? Work overheads, which is also known as factory overheads, factory on cost. There are so many names. But remember this, work overheads or factory overhead. Whatever expenditure related to factory. Indirect expenditure, whatever, right? Factory cleaning, fuel, oil, whatever it will be, right? Factory related, factory supervisor salary, work manager salary, factory manager salary. These all are the factory overheads. And beta, remember this word, overheads is very important. Overhead means what? Indirect expenditure. This word says what? Overhead means what? Indirect expenditure. Remember this. What is overhead? Overhead is what? Indirect expenditure. If you see this word directly, this is what indirect expense. Direct click hona chahiye, direct click. Ki this overhead is what? Indirect expenditure. Now, in work overheads, whatever factory overheads, whatever factory related expenses will be shown. And after that, less, what you have to deduct it? Less sale of scrap. What? Sale of scrap, right? If you have sold some scrap, what? If you have sold some scrap, kuch scrap nikal gaya production ke time pe. If you have sold that what? You will get some income na. And you are preparing here what? Cost sheet. Cost means all the expenditure. So what is the work of income? That income will reduce your cost to the extent. That is why we have to reduce this sale of scrap from this overheads, right? So this expenditure will get reduced by those amount, right? Like this is 1000 and sale of scrap is 200. Now the cost will come 800. So our cost will reduce na, because this is what scrap sale. Arey bangar bechte na bhai, bangar se kuch paisa mil gaya. That is the thing. So utna burden thoda reduce hota hai. That's it. So this is what work overheads or factory overhead, less sale of scrap. And after that, beta, whatever work in progress, raw material ka to dekh liya direct. Now, if some raw material in process, that is what फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड से रिलेटेड. सो इफ इट इज इन प्रोसेस, राइट, है प्रोसेस फैक्ट्री में ही होगा ना, प्रोसेस में सेम फंडा. यू हैव टू एड ओपनिंग स्टॉक एंड यू हैव टू लेस क्लोजिंग स्टॉक. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दिस. सी इन डायरेक्ट मटेरियल ऑल्सो रॉ मटेरियल ओपनिंग स्टॉक हैज बीन एडेड एंड रॉ मटेरियल क्लोजिंग स्टॉक हैज बीन डिडक्टेड. सेम हियर इन वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस, ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस यू हैव टू एड इट एंड क्लोजिंग स्टॉक ऑफ वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस यू हैव टू डिडक्ट इट. सिंपल, राइट है. सो एड ओपनिंग स्टॉक ऑफ वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस, लास्ट ईयर वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस विल बी ब्रॉट फॉरवर्ड एंड whatever closing stock of work in progress left, right, that you have to reduce it, right? So after reducing, proper hai, you will get this amount. Means you have to calculate all this. Now see, if this amount is 1000, sale of scrap is 200, so answer will come 800. Now,
800.
Yes, if the opening stock is 100, then 800 plus 100, 900, and closing stock is 200. Then what will be the answer? 700. 200 minus karne baad, you will get 700. Okay? Clear? Okay. So this is what work overhead or factory overhead funda. That you have to remember it. Okay? Now, bacha, after remembering this, if you will get all these steps right there, now what to do? Now, whatever, see this amount, right? This amount, and those last prime cost amount. Assume prime cost is what? Assume prime cost is 10,000, right? And this amount is 700. So 10,000 plus 700, now this will be 10,700, right? So this is known as what? Work cost. What we will say? This is what? Works cost, right? So remember, bachalo, this factory overhead. What to do? Work overhead or factory overhead? Whatever expenditure will be there, less sale of scrap, then work in progress, opening stock will be added, closing stock will be deducted. Finally, you will get the amount here. And after that, that prime cost amount plus this, whatever amount you will get, that is what your works cost. You can see that whatever main headings, main pointers, I have highlighted in green. Very important. First, prime cost. And after that, we will get what? Works cost. What? Work cost. How we will get work cost? Prime cost plus work overhead. Work overhead means factory overhead. Prime cost plus work overhead. Ka pura calculation karne ke baad, we will get works cost. Work cost. Got it? Now, move to next. After work cost, what we have to do? I told you yesterday I have told you there are three main indirect expenditure, indirect overheads. Work overheads, done. Now, office and administration overheads. Second one was what? Second one is office and admin overhead. Office related, jo bhi kharcha. Office rent, office salary, staff salary, audit fees. Auditor will come, he will audit it, right? So audit fees, whatever official related expenditure are there that we have to add it. Right? After adding this, what we will get, bacha? We will get cost of production. What we will get? We will get cost of production. So how we will get this? Work cost. And in work cost, what we have to do? We have to add all office and administration overheads. Then add it. We will get what? Our cost of production. What we will get, bacha? We will get cost of production. Okay? Cost of production, clear? Now, after cost of production means cost of production has been done. It means our material processed into finished goods. Right? Our product is ready. Now, after cost of production, finished goods step is there. What? Finished goods. Now, in finished goods, same procedure, opening stock add, closing stock less. Same procedure, bacha. Opening stock of finished goods added, last year finished goods will be brought forward and current year finished goods stock will be deducted, right? So finished goods, same, opening stock added, closing stock deducted, right? Clear? In work in process also you have seen, opening stock of work in progress, see this one, opening stock of work in progress added, closing stock of work in progress deducted, right? In raw material also, direct material wale formula mein, opening stock of raw material added, starting mein, and closing stock of raw material deducted. Means the common thing is what? You have to add opening stock. For getting the cost, you have to add opening stock and deduct closing stock. That's it. Right? And that stock pertains to either raw materials or work in progress or finished goods. Clear, beta? Okay. Now, see, after cost of production, what will be the next step? Finished goods. Same. Finished goods mein, same, beta. What we have to add? What we have to add opening stock of finished goods and we have to deduct closing stock of finished goods. And after doing this, what we will get? Cost of goods sold. See one example. Let's take one example. If your cost of production is 12,000, and opening stock of finished goods is 1,000. So total will be, calculator rahega directly, total 13,000. And closing stock of finished goods is 2,000. So 13 minus 2, what? 11,000. What? 13 minus 2, 11,000. And this 11,000 will be what? Your cost of goods sold. What? Cost of goods sold. Clear? Right? So, see, after getting cost of production, what you have to do? You have to add opening stock of finished goods and deduct closing stock of finished goods. Right? Then you have what? You have your cost of goods sold. What you will get? Cost of goods sold. Clear? Okay, beta? Now, move to next. After cost of goods sold, now you have to market that. You have to follow the marketing strategy, distribution strategy. And in marketing or distribution strategy, whatever will be there, whatever expenditure will be there, that is what your indirect expenditure, bacha. That is known as selling and distribution overheads. If you will give salesman salary, salesman commission, that is what? For the purpose of selling and distribution only. Advertisement, free samples, all that are selling and distribution overheads. That is sales and distribution overheads. What? Sales and distribution overheads. So sales and distribution overhead will be shown, whatever expenditure, with the total of selling and distribution overheads. Then cost of goods sold plus whatever selling and distribution overheads will be there, add it, you will get cost of sales. What you will get, beta? You will get cost of sales. So let's take an example. Cost of goods sold is what? 11,000. And all the selling and distribution overhead is what? 2,000. Like your all the selling and distribution overhead is how much? 2,000. So 11 plus 2 is what? Simple, 13. Okay, clear? So that 13 will be nothing but what? Your cost of sales. That 13,000 will be your what, beta? Cost of sales. Clear? How to get cost of sales? How to get cost of sale? Cost of goods sold. And then what? Add it, selling and distribution overhead. You have to add it, all the selling and distribution overhead, add it. Then you will get what? Cost of sales. Clear? Correct? Eh? Now, after cost of sales, what do you have to do? Right? You have derived, your cost of sales is what? 13,000. Now, business company will decide how much profit we have to take. What will be the profit margin? Now, company has decided the profit margin will be 10%. Now, 13,000 is cost of sales. 10% will be profit margin. So 13,000, 10% of 13,000 is what? 1,300. 10% of 13,000 is what? 1300. So that 1300 will be your profit. And beta profit hai, so it will be added, right? Profit margin will be added. And finally, you will decide your selling price. Your sales will be there, right? If it is one, if it is per unit, then this will be your per unit sale price. If it is total, then it will be your total sales, right? So that is what your sales. Now, in our example, normally 13,000 plus 1300, kitna ho gaya beta? 14,300. And that 14,300 will be our sales. That 14,300 will be our sales, right? So up to cost of sales is very important that you can know about the product cost after adding all the above prime cost and this work overheads, this office and admin overheads, this selling and distribution overheads, then only you will get cost of sales, right? And after adding cost of sales, rubber hai, sab kuch add kar diya, right? After cost of sales, you have to add what? Profit margin. What you have to add, beta? Profit margin. And finally, you will get your sales. Finally, you will get your sales. Clear? Malum pad gaya, bacha? So this cost sheet is very important, right? Ye cost sheet ko ekdam by heart karne ke basis pe properly ekdam short and sweet bana ke diye acche se yaad karna, right? Simple. Now clear? This is what your cost sheet or roll number. फटाफट सब लोग अपना डाल दो और roll number last 2-3 minutes में ही डालना है बेटा, right? है clear? हाँ, वो 10:37 के पहले डालेगा तो consider नहीं होगा, इसलिए 10:37 तक मैं दे रहा हूँ. 10:37 से उसके बाद you have to put your roll number. 10:37, 10:38, 10:39, 10:40 पे तो finish हो जाए, right? है. So this is what your cost sheet, and everyone have to revise today this cost sheet at home. Everyone have to revise it, everyone have to by heart it, because this will definitely give you 20 marks, right? Hai to beta fatafat ek bar review. Sabse first apna main direct cost, all the direct cost, direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, you will get what? Prime cost. What beta? Prime cost. After prime cost, work overheads, factory overheads will be added, then sale of scrap, after that work in progress opening added, closing stock deducted, right? So whatever amount you will get and prime cost amount, both will be added, you will get work cost. What you will get? Work cost. And after work cost, office and admin plus kiya to cost of production, fir cost of production ke baad finished goods opening stock, and finished goods opening stock will be added, closing stock will be deducted. You will get cost of goods sold. Then selling and distribution overhead will be added. You will get cost of sales. After that, profit margin. Whatever profit margin you will take, 10%, 20%, that you have to add. And finally, you will get your sale price. So this is very important. Very important cost sheet, beta. Achche se revise karna. Properly ekdam. Ab lecture kabhi bhi.